Hey, how's it going? My name is Jonathan. Thank you for clicking on this video where I am going to show you how to live stream with a mirrorless camera. In this case, I'm using the G85, which is right here sitting on the table. I just got the Blackmagic, I forget what it's called. UltraStudio mini recorder. Yesterday I opened it, I unboxed it, and I could not for the life of me figure out how to get it working. It was not intuitive from a, you know, open the box, get up and running quick perspective, but after about 30 minutes of research last night and tinkering with it a little bit today in between naps and feeding and all of that, putting the kids down, I figured it out, so I want to share that with you, okay? So this video is how to get up and running with live stream, specifically on YouTube, specifically with a G85, yes, camera. So you're gonna open this thing up, I covered this yesterday, you're gonna plug in the micro HDMI to your camera like this. Micro HDMI, from what I understand, it works with any camera that outputs true HDMI, so you'll wanna check that. G85 does work. And then from here, you'll plug in the other end to the actual box, I'll call it. This mini recorder, the Blackmagic recorder. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna plug this into your computer, into your Thunderbolt input. All right, so once you do that, sorry, as you can tell, I didn't plan for this video very well. It's gonna be a live stream, so there you have it. When you plug it in, you'll see that there's a light here. I don't know if I could get it at the right angle, but you can see the light is on. That's how you know it's on. And yesterday, I was just trying to kind of like plug and play and go, but actually, you know, I'm the type that doesn't read manuals and instructions, so that's kind of why it didn't work right off the bat. But hey, if your product works well, it shouldn't need that, right? I mean, that's why people love Google and Apple. Anyways, I digress. So what you're gonna do is, if you remember from yesterday, this thing came with a little micro SD card right here that says software and manual. You're gonna need to put that into your computer and install the actual software that comes on it, which I guess kind of makes sense, right? It's like, if you install a printer, you need a driver, right? How is your computer gonna know how to talk to your printer? Same thing here. How is your computer supposed to know, you know, what this box is doing and that it's here? Again, if it was a good product and you know, if it worked the way I feel like it should, you would plug it in and then it would start working, right? It would install the drivers, etc. So I don't know why it works like this, but it just does. Anyways, you put the micro SD in, you'll get something like this, and you probably can't see it from the screen, but you'll see four icons. One of these icons says install desktop video. That's the actual piece of software that runs and basically tells your computer, like, hey, there's this Blackmagic box, and you know, here's how to talk to it, right? So once you install it, which I already did already, you're gonna wanna launch that. So it's a desktop video, video setup. I'm gonna click on it again. It's gonna launch. It's basically a picture here of the Blackmagic Studio Ultra whatever recorder. And you're gonna click on this video input. If it's just blank and grayed out, that means it's not talking to your camera. Okay, so what you're gonna do is you're gonna make sure, you know, all your connections are in. And then also you're gonna make sure your camera's on. So in my case, it was not on. So I'm gonna turn it on. And it's gonna say no memory card because I don't have one. What is not, actually I'm running out of batteries. Give me one second here while I switch battery. Just doing this in real time. All right, so here we go. I'm gonna turn it on again. It's gonna say no memory card. And what is not readily apparent is how do you actually set up your camera for output or you know, live stream? And basically I hit menu and then it does this blackout kind of thing. And I'm like, okay, what's going on? And then it says TV output in progress. So at this point, I'm guessing that this camera is outputting an HDMI video. here in this interface here, it's not picking it up because I can see it says video input and it's still grayed out. So I'm gonna click on this guy. I'm gonna say, hey, it's HDMI. I don't want any conversion, and hit save. And then if it works right, it'll pick up the video output here. It'll say 1080p, 30 frames per second. Right now it's not doing it just yet. So what I'm gonna do is I am going to, I wonder how to like refresh this. So I think I'm just gonna unplug it and plug it back in. And maybe that'll kick it into gear. I don't know. So there it goes. Blah, blah, blah. HDMI, save. It's still not picking up the feed for whatever reason. So that's interesting. It was working this morning. I don't know what the deal is here. So I'm just gonna troubleshoot this. My camera is tied to my box. Everything's happy. The light is on. Try to again hit menu on my camera. It does blackout. It says TV output in progress. Well, I don't know. Let me move on to the other piece here. The other piece is gonna be OBS or Open Broadcast Software. Open Broadcaster software. And this is, give me 1 second here. Don't know why my Finder is not actually like finding it, so apologies for that. There it goes, just type in OBS. So let me cover this while, I don't know, while my camera rests from this mini recorder thing. So yesterday I got confused because I was trying to add a source here on the bottom left. I was hitting the plus arrow and basically all I found was like, the closest thing was video capture device, and the Blackmagic device was not populating here. And that is because I did not install the software. So once you install the software, this menu item will come up right here. It says Blackmagic device, and then you can actually select the box as a streaming device. So once you click on that, you'll see a menu, and you know, you can basically stick with the default settings. That's what I did. And then when it's all finally up and running and working, this black box that you see here will have the image from your camera. So that is the piece that is not working just yet. I'm not exactly sure why. So, you know, this morning, this input thing said, you know, it did say, 1080p, 30 frames per second. I don't know how to refresh this. It seems like, you know, they just need like a refresh of some sort. Maybe I can close it out and open it again. I don't know. So there it is. So you can't see that right here, but it says video input HDMI and it's grayed out. When it was working earlier, it said 1080p, 30 frames per second. I feel like I repeated that 3 times, but it's okay. Blah, blah, blah. Still not working. I don't know why. So I'm just kind of like messing with it and pressing. Oh, I'm pressing. I just pressed the shutter button, I think that worked because now I can see this image here on Open Broadcast Software. So that was weird. Not sure what's up with that. But anyways, if I click on this icon now, it says right here where it used to be grayed out, it says 1080p, 30 frames per second. Basically, all I did was I pressed the shutter, which is really weird because I thought that this was supposed to say TV output in progress, which I guess, you know, they both work at the same time. I don't know. That's weird. Anyways, when you come back to Open Broadcast Software, your image is up. So there you go. That's how you do it. Kind of a scattered-brained video, but here are the steps. I'm going to summarize the steps for you, okay? Step 1, plug everything in, plug your camera in, make sure you have batteries, plug it into the Blackmagic box, plug the Blackmagic box into your computer. That's step one. Step two is make sure you have the software installed, the Blackmagic software, which comes into the disk, or which comes in the SD card. So install that, pretty straightforward to install. Step three is make sure you have OBS, Open Broadcaster Software, installed. And then you can follow the video that I mentioned yesterday, I'll link it up here, of how to actually set up the Open Broadcast software with YouTube Live. All right, so you know, yesterday I thought that I could just follow that video and be up and running, but I forgot the first step, which is to install the actual desktop video, the software that comes with Blackmagic, okay? So once you do that, you're good to go. If you get an error about 4K, it's because I believe this UltraStudio mini recorder doesn't support 4K, so if you have a Panasonic camera and you have it set to 4K right here, you'll need to change that to the single frame or single whatever window. So that's how you get up and running. Now you can see, like, as I move the camera, the image there is working. So this is probably my last live stream on my cell phone, which only does 720p, which is the whole reason why I got this thing in the first place. Wanted to stream at a higher quality. Wanted to use this hardware that I bought already, invested in. I have two lens now, and I have a body which is pretty solid. I mean, it's not the top of the line, but it's good enough for my purpose. So I wanted to make use of that to stream. I hope this video was helpful for you. Now you can turn your mirrorless camera into a streaming device. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to help you out. And the next live stream you see will be from this guy. So thanks for watching again. Make it a great day. If you're interested in father related videos, go ahead and subscribe, and keep yourself updated. I do like this techie sort of stuff, so maybe I'll make more videos like this. Check out the links below if you're interested, and just let me know if you have any questions. I'm just happy to help you out. All right, have a great day. Bye.